Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. It's Joffy Noodle Legs here today with Sullivan. He's going to want to come and say hello. Come on in, mate. Up he pop. Here he comes. Come on. Come on in. Here he comes. Come on in. Here he is. There's Sullivan.
Hello, everybody.
Beautiful boy. Here we are today with another noodle film with you. Are you always tired? With another noodle film with you. Today, as it's obviously it's October, we're still looking at the horror movies. So today we're looking at Hellfest. This is a sort of real typical film made for Halloween, really. So this edition, it's just a DVD, guys. Nothing sort of like special about it. Just a DVD, the movie. Special features, doesn't really have any, has a trailer, that's it. But there we go. As you saw at the beginning of the video, you saw the girl in like a sort of haunted fair sort of ride thing, and then you saw a guy with a mask's head turn. So the killer doesn't take too long to put himself into the film. This is the first minutes of the film. And then he carries on sort of following her through the ride.
Another scared?
And there you go, he's following her through the ride, and eventually he catches up with her and he kills her. And then he sort of strings her up, hangs her up in the ride, and she becomes a part of the ride, and people don't know that she's missing. And that's all happening in the title screen. So then we're out of the title screen and we start the main story, and we're at a house. And this is where we meet sort of like some of the main teens of the film. And first of all, we meet sort of like the innocent teenager, the main sort of girl in the story.
Thank you so much.
So she's arrived, and most of her friends are pleased to see her. That sort of young one with the short hair, there is a little bit of sort of like, I don't know, disagreement between the pair of them. Nothing major, but there's a bit of disagreement between them. Anyway, then they go upstairs, the two of the girls, that our main sort of girl and her friend, they go upstairs and they start talking about guys, as they do, and talking about going out for this... to the Halloween fair called Hellfest.
But, you're not wearing that, right? Why? What is wrong with what I'm wearing?
Nat, it's Halloween. It's the one night out of the year you're allowed to let out. You're in a slut.
Yeah, I don't think I have one of those.
Natalie, I didn't think you were gonna make it.
Can you not? Hi, yeah, no, I'm here. I don't know why everyone thinks I'm not gonna be here.
What? No, I knew you were coming. Brooke was the one I was like,
can you not do that? What are you in here for?
I'm ready. You guys ready? You ready for Hellfest? You look ready.
Baby, we need 10 minutes.
We have to meet Gavin at will call. We're going to be late.
Big!
So there we go. And this movie's not wasting any time, because we're then cut straight to the evening to and the guys on their way to Hellfest.
Whoa,
whoa, whoa, whoa,
whoa,
whoa, you're not flipping, it happens like in Orange Girl.
Oh yeah, that was fucked up.
Wait, what? Oh, well, a couple years ago, a girl got completely gutted in a haunted house, like for real.
The killer left her body in the park for 3 days. No one found her until she started to stink. They thought she was a freaking cop.
Wait, that's brutal. Man, what can I say? Some people are just evil. I mean, they're monsters. To them, every single day is Halloween. They dress up, so you know what?
So as you see, they're entering the Hellfest sort of like area, and it is like a sort of Halloween based sort of like fair, like a sort of like theme park sort of thing. But it's not a theme park; it's they call it a moving sort of park, and it's not. It's a in the UK it's called a fun fair, but it's all based around sort of Halloween and sort of scary rides. And here we meet two other of the lads, and one of the lads that is sort of like who fancies the main girl of the story.
Your dinner fears will come true.
Whoa, is that her? That's just there. I don't know. You might actually have to pretend you're here tonight.
So then we got the whole team together, and they're just sort of like planning their sort of night out around the Hellfest.
It's not that bad.
Not the worst thing.
It is time for shots.
Yes.
Then it cuts to again to the big to the entrance of the fair, and then we sort of see some guy approaching the fair. We only see him from behind walking and entering the actual fair, and he is our killer. So that's our killer. He has now entered the fair, and it's sort of like it sort of follows him around the fair a little bit, sort of bumping into sort of teenagers. And with that, he sort of like he then sort of follows those girls that he just bumped into, and it cuts back to our group, who it tries to show them having sort of clips of them trying to show them having sort of fun on some of the sort of like attractions.
More scary scene, the more they come after you. You gotta like,
it's just to relax.
Play it cool. Yes.
Oh, yes. Oh my god. Yeah. No, Wait, cool. I'll remember. That's great.
I have a very specific phobia of demon clowns.
Okay, so it's just trying to sort of like paint a picture of them having fun, this sort of rides, and you get like all different things, and they're having jump scares and stuff like this from some of the spooks that are in sort of like some of the attractions. And it gets to the three girls are in one of the attractions, and just as they're going sort of like near, they see another girl sort of running in. Okay, so there you go, you see this girl running in, and then you see our killer coming in. They all think it is a part of the actual the attraction, and they go, oh yeah, the girl's in there, she's down there. So he picks her out and grabs her, and two of the girls sort of go, oh, this is just dumb, and they go, and our main sort of character, she stays there watching, because she still believes it's a part of the actual ride. She goes, well, go on then, kill it then. And he does. And then she sort of stood there in shock, thinking, is this real or not? So now she's not quite sure if it's real or if it's just fake or part of the show. She just felt that something wasn't right. And then the killer starts sort of stalking her about.
Looks like you made a friend.
Great school.
Oh, this doesn't rhyme like a baby in there, college.
So. Okay, all right, I might like you. Let's keep going. Keep it up.
Anyway, she carries on with the evening in the end, and she just thinks, oh, it's just part of the actual theme park. And then we catch up with her chatting to the young lad that they're sort of like showing an interest in each other, and she says, come on, let's go into this photo booth.
Nice to be in hell.
Yep. Nice to be in hell.
Nice place to be.
Yeah.
Oh god.
But that was like
okay. Oh god, I'm so bad at these things.
I need to be in here.
Yeah, okay.
Smile. Just smiling, baby. Not that you're in it.
No, that's just right. That's really the only way I know how to do it.
Anyway, you can see he's still stalking her, and they're in the photo booth and they're doing all these photos, and he comes up to the photo booth and he takes the photographs that are coming out and sort of walks off of them, and one of the girl's friends sees it and sort of tries to follow him, but she loses him. Actually, she gets a bit scared and spooked and comes back. So yeah, he's sort of really sort of stalking them. And that's pretty much what he's doing. He's just stalking her and her friends around the fair. And that's all I'm going to tell you. Now, this is a typical slasher film. It's not an old film, but it's got a real sort of 80s feel to it. like a sort of 80s, maybe sort of like a 90s sort of feel to the film. And it is a proper no big story slasher. It's about a killer stalking this group of kids, killing them off one by one around the fair. And it's great fun. It's really, really cool. So what do I think of the film? Yeah, it is great fun. It's a really good film. I really enjoyed watching it. Some quite intense moments in it as well. Especially sort of like nearer the end when the girls are trying to get away and hide from him. And he's sort of like there and just stalking them through the things. And he does. There is some quite cool deaths in there as well. It's quite cool. It's a little bit of gore, not too much. But yeah, there's some good deaths in it as well, which I really, really like. And the killer's quite cool. It's a little bit of a Michael Myers vibe going on. It is a very Halloween sort of influence sort of film. So if you love Halloween and films like that, and maybe Scream, Valentine, I know you did last summer, all those sort of films, this is going to be your type of movie. It's along all those sort of lines. It's a good, fun popcorn slasher movie. Nothing more, nothing taken out, nothing put in. The pluses of the film, it's great fun. The atmosphere of the film's really cool. It is quite spooky. I think the killer's quite cool in it, and he is some quite spooky bits. It's quite a good ending as well. I love the ending. And then the negatives, the teens can be a little bit annoying, but as teens, isn't it, they can be a little bit annoying. And it's very, I don't like some of the silly sort of like, some of the fairs a bit stupid, where it's like I almost got like a disco going on in there. It's just like, but although that would be cool, wouldn't it, if there was something like this going around on sort of like Halloween. I would love to go to something like this on Halloween. But yeah, that was, and yeah, the only other real negative is UK. Why no Blu-ray again? No Blu-ray release, just DVD. It's so frustrating in this country. DVD is still quite a big seller in the UK. A lot of people still just buy DVDs. But it's really unfair to the people that buy Blu-rays, because they know they can make the money off the DVDs. So they just seem to release the DVDs. It's a bit of a shame. Right, what am I going to score this film? A great watch. It's an 8 out of 10 for me. It's definitely a Halloween movie for a Halloween night, sitting there with a sort of like mindless, not have to think about it story. Great sort of kills and jump scares, and you know, it's always great watching the teens get their comeuppance, if you like, because they're all over each other kissing and all. Oh, yeah, and that's a bit of annoying, but so it's a good slasher movie. I would highly recommend it if you've not seen it. It's just good fun, you know. If you love the Scream films and that, you're in for a treat. It's really, really cool. 8 out of 10. So that's my little review of Hellfest, which was in my video on my channel saying 10 awesome movies to watch on Halloween night. If you've not seen that, go over and have a little look, see if there's something there you fancy. Have any of you seen it? What did you think of it? Write down below, let me know. It is a good little fun film. You know, it's not to be taken serious. It's from the producers of The Walking Dead. It's nothing like The Walking Dead. It's just a fun slasher movie. And the killer's quite cool. And it is left wide open. So that's all I'm going to say. Until the next video, go and check out some channels for me. Horror Hands, Horror Geek, Man V Film, Pizzlewell, I Am the Ice Lord, RS Designs, Sarah of Horror. Go and check all these amazing channels out for me, guys. Until next time, you look after yourselves, look after one another, and I really hope I see you all soon.